Howdy, folks. You know, back in 2020, when we realized that we were not going to have a typical Lake Superior Big Top Chautauqua season, we started recording little snippets of performances of music, interviews, storytelling, going back into the archives and digging out some video of performances from years gone by. We put them all together in what we called Tiny Tent Shows. We did over 40 Tiny Tent Shows. And what you're about to see now is a rebroadcast, an encore airing, if you will, of a previously recorded Tiny Tent Show. Thank you so much for supporting us, and we look forward to seeing you back beneath the canvas. Howdy, folks, and welcome to Tiny Tent Show, episode number 36. Tonight we bring you the music and an interview with Two Below Zero. More on that in a minute. But first, a somber note. Mary Rice died this week. Mary was one of the founders of Lake Superior Big Top Chautauqua. In fact, talk to anybody involved and they will tell you that Big Top would not exist if not for Mary. Those same people, and hundreds, if not thousands, of others will tell you that Mary was the queen of Bayfield, Wisconsin. It's impossible to walk through that little town and not see some physical evidence of her lifelong dedication to invigorating the lives of those around her. Her presence and philanthropy extend far beyond this small Wisconsin town to people and institutions all around the state, and indeed all around the world. From pink flamingos to fine dining, Mary Rice left a legacy. It's a legacy that I can't possibly adequately address in this moment or in this medium. But as we pick up after this tumultuous time and prepare to move forward, we know this. We have the momentum of Mary behind us. Before we move to the music of Two Below Zero, thank you for tuning in. Thank you for supporting us past, present, and future. We take none of it for granted. If you're able, a virtual tip jar is up during this show. And you can also arrange to continue the legacy of Mary Rice by contacting the Lake Superior Big Top Chautauqua offices and arranging a donation through those channels. Also, please rebroadcast this show on your social media channels if you have the opportunity. Later in the show, I'll interview Nate Bean and Mark Phillips, the duo known as Two Below Zero. It was a fun ramble. But for now, I'm happy to virtually welcome you to the Big Top and just let you hear the beautifully blended harmonies and blended guitars as well of Nate and Mark, in the form of Two Below Zero.
For those shoes, and I know that I don't know you well, but holding your hand I can tell that if I ever lost you I'd be crazed. And the sunny field is darkened by the shadow. Later days, later days, later. driving, what I'm drinking are, in essence, just the things that make me free. We're not moving on the freeway. There's got to be a new way to get my things from point A to point B. And the sunny field is darkened by the shadow.
Thank you very much. Thank you. It's fun to be up here on this stage, especially this time of year when normally I think the stage is all torn down. So we kind of feel like we're stealing a little extra time.
This might be the last weekend. I think they do the brew weekend. The what do they call that? Blues and brews? No, that's something else. We're going to have to work on that pattern. We're called Two Below Zero, guys. We're from right around here in the Bayfield, Washburn, Ashland area. And it's so nice to be here tonight playing for you.
No matter what you are, I will always be with you. Nothing would be, no matter.
Nate and I are both big fans of the Beatles, and I don't know, it's hard to trust someone who's not a Beatles fan, I found, but I do have a few friends like that, so there's exceptions to every rule.
You know, it's not a great story, but it's actually the one of the first times I ever got to play here at the Big Top was for a Beatles show, and Corey called me, and because he knows I love the Beatles, I know he loved the Beatles, and so he brought me into it, and it was a lot of work, and it was a lot of fun.
I don't know, I remember sitting out in the audience here and watching you get up on stage and play with the amazing Robert Randolph one night, so that was a pretty cool memory for me just to see you playing up here that night with them. My first time playing here, I was 17 years old. And things were just getting started really out here then, and I was playing in a symphony, playing trumpet in a symphony. And if any of you have ever played trumpet in a symphony, you might know that you spend a lot of time sitting in your chair waiting for your moment to come. And so on this particular day, we were all set up in the grass because there was no room in the tent for a symphony and the audience. So as I was sitting there waiting tacitly for my big break, this little chipmunk popped up right in this hole right by my music stand. And he stood right by my music stand and kind of looked at me. And he stayed that way for a couple minutes. And then my solo came up, and I was afraid I was going to blow it, you know, because I was really intent on this chipmunk. But I played the solo and did it well, and I finished, and pop, you went right back down the hole. So that was my first time here. I was 17, and it's a great memory that stuck with me a long time.
I've just seen the face, I can't forget the time or place where we just met. She's just a girl for me, and I'm one of the world to see we've met. Had it been another day, I might have looked the other way, and I'd have never been aware. But as it is, I'll dream of her tonight. Falling, yes, I am falling, and she keeps calling me back again. Of this I've been alone, and I have missed things and kept out of sight. But other girls were never quite like this. Nah, 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 nah. Falling, yes I am falling, and she keeps calling me back again. Calling me back again. I have seen the face, I can't forget the time or place where we just met. She's just a girl for me, and I'm one of the world to see we met. La, na, 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 na. I'm falling, yes I am falling, and she keeps calling me back again.
Thanks, that's the Beatles.
I hope you know how nice it is to see you lying in my bed. My blankets all around you, yeah. Realize that every night I dream of humming birds that fly around you. Yeah, yeah. Don't get me wrong. Come down, let me put my arms around you, as if I found you down and out, my friend. I pick you up off the ground. If I found you there, I know I would. Let's go for a drive in the mountains and drink some wine. Forget about trying. Been with my miss sleepy eyes.
Nate and I have played in a couple different bands around this area over the years. We started Two Below Zero, was it about 2013 or so? We had a really horrendous winter here. It was below zero for, I think, about 70 or 75 days in a row.
And I think that number gets bigger every time you tell that
story.
It was
90, actually. But it just seemed to never end. And a friend of ours was putting together a show over in Ashland and looking for acoustic acts to play that, and talked us into it. And so last minute, we just kind of said, well, what are we going to call ourselves? And Nate said, Two Below Zero. And that was it. So the nice thing about that name is if we have people sit in with us and stuff, then, you know, it's real easy to just change it to Three Below Zero, Four Below Zero. And we get cooler every time. So.
Now I know my love for her goes on. Every little thing she does is magic.
Thank you very much.
Again, so happy to be with you here tonight with Tiny Tent Show. And what a fun thing this has been all through this strange time we've experienced together. Seeing all of our favorites from the tent shows and of course, all the musicians. And it's really been a neat thing. So thank you for keeping that going. And your support, of course, helps that so much. So we thank you and definitely looking forward to a great season next year here under the tent, under the stars.
Love me forever.
Forever and a day.
We hope you've had a wonderful time enjoying Tiny Tent Show, and we'd like you to share that joy by participating in our New Year's Day episode by sending us a 15 to 30 second video of you letting us know your favorite memory of Tiny Tent Show. Videos can be creative, silly, or anything you want it to be. Your smiling face and message will be stitched together in a montage video quilt made of memories from 2020. To upload your video, just go to bigtop.org/upload and follow the instructions. We do encourage you to just use a simple cell phone video. That'll make it easy to share your message. Folks, when I heard Nate and Mark singing together, I looked forward to learning about what brought them together and how they got to this point. So we met up online and we discussed exactly that, with bonus references to the Fudge Wagon. Well, I want to welcome Nate Bean and Mark Phillips, otherwise known as Two Below. Is that a two with a digit or with a word?
It's been both. I would say a word. It's Two Below Zero is the full name.
Two Below Zero. And yeah. I'm commiserating just because I have a band I go out with sometimes, and I call them the Long Beds after my old pickup truck. And everyone always makes it one word, and it was never supposed to be one word. But you know what? That's on me. So Two Below, spelling out two below zero, excuse me, spelling out the T-W-O. Well, it's great to talk to you, fellas. Nate and I already joke that we coordinated our outfits. Had no idea.
I did not, but I do have a lumberjack shirt I could throw on.
You could just run and get that and complete the trifecta.
Mark, you didn't check your email. Mark didn't check his email.
Yeah, we didn't coordinate.
You got to come to the meetings, man. Well, let's just start out with the basics. Nate, if you just want to talk a little bit about, first of all, where you're talking to us from right this minute, and then a little bit about your background.
I'm actually in my basement right now. It's surprisingly warm down here and quiet. So that's where I'm joining you all from. I live in Ashland, Wisconsin. I'm currently a teacher, English teacher at Ashland High School. And I spend many hours a day on Zoom meetings just like these.
Yeah.
So I kind of feel at home right now.
Well, two things come to mind. First of all, thank you. Teachers are just, they're always doing such good work for us. I'm speaking as a parent right now, but in these times especially, just full credit to you folks for doing what you can with what you've been given. Really appreciate it. On a slightly more nervous note, so it's been alleged that I'm a writer, and so people think that I know English really good, and I get really nervous when I talk to English teachers because I write by ear, and I don't know about dangling participles and the past pluperfect and all that stuff. So if we get to a who-whom situation, I'll be taking three left turns to try and avoid it.
I think you'll be all right. I might be a bigger fan than I let on. So
I'm happy to be corrected. And so, Mark, go ahead and tell us a little bit about where you're sitting right now and also your background.
I'm sitting here at home in my sanctum sanctorum, I guess, where all my music stuff is, and so that's kind of where I like to be. And I live in Washburn, but our business is in Bayfield, so I spend a lot of time up there. Mm-hmm. We have a bed and breakfast, country inn, gourmet restaurant called the Old Rittenhouse Inn. Mm-hmm. That my family has run for 45 years now. Wow. So I'm fully engaged with that, but music has always been, you know, catharsis and time with friends and just, you know, joy for me. So I've tried to keep that really active through the years.
You know, I was gonna save this for later, but let's just jump into that right now. The idea of music and musicians, and both of you have talked about, one of you teaches, one of you helps run this family business. And even in my case, if you're going to survive out there, you have to have, especially during these times, you have to have different streams of income streams, I guess you call them. And if you could just maybe speak to the idea that there are wonderfully talented artists and musicians walking around all over the place, and maybe someone sees you, Mark, at the Rittenhouse and has no idea what you can do with a guitar. And Nate, perhaps your students don't necessarily know that you can harmonize beautifully with Mark. And so maybe just speak to that, you know, where does that line cross? People are sometimes say, well, I'm not a real writer because I don't do it full time. Well, that's ridiculous. If you spend the time, if you work at the art, you're a writer. So maybe if you could both speak to the role the music plays in your life.
You want to go first, Mark?
Sure. Well, I mean, you know, I when I was in the womb kicking, my mom would play Chopin nocturnes. And so I had this classical music all through my youth, you know, and then I kind of got into more like rock and stuff. And in this community here, I always kind of joked that you could just pick up a rock and throw it and you'd hit a guitarist or some kind of musician or artist or, you know, the people that work with glass and jewelry or stones they find in Lake Superior and make them into these beautiful pieces, and metal workers, and, you know, even beer brewers are a craftsman in our area too, and things like that. And there's just so much of that up here. It seems like almost everyone has some kind of side of that. And then of course they all have to make a living too. And so it is, there's a lot of people that have even 2-3 businesses they run. Like they do a wonderful sailing and stuff in the summer, and then they do dog sledding in the winter, or they have these adventure shops, you know, and just people like that are, you know, I just admire them, and I guess I try to be like that too a little bit.
Yeah, for me, it's always been about friendship and those people that I've hung out with. Even I'm thinking of the friend of mine who taught me how to play guitar. We were friends for 2 or 3 years before I even knew he played guitar, and then so, you know, we would just play together, and then every friend I've had since then has been a musician, and it's just been a great way to spend time being with friends is playing music.
I think that's the thing. It's not so much how you identify yourself. It's that it just expands your capacity for joy, really. You can just hang out with a whole different group of folks. I think, you know, if you think backstage at the Big Top, when we actually have audiences and you're actually there with a crew, everybody is rooted in the arts. But as you just said, you can go right around the room and so-and-so was a mechanic and so-and-so worked on the sawmill, and somebody else has, like you said, sled dogs. And I think that people talk about Nashville. I remember going to Nashville and they'd say back in the day when people actually pumped your gas, they'd say the guy pumping your gas is a world-class guitarist, and the woman waiting tables at the pancake house is a fabulous singer. And I just think that I appreciate you highlighting that the folks around you are often repositories of talent that you don't suspect. What?
Yeah. And even I think our gigs, like a lot of times someone will be there and, you know, it might be Randy Sabine or, you know, or whatever. And it's like all of a sudden you have this amazing fiddle player just blowing people's minds, or he'll sit in on keys and, you know, make your song 10 times better than it was. And, you know, so we're fortunate to have fun things like that happen too quite a bit.
You know, that touches on something that I meant to get to also, and that is the beauty of a place like up there in Washburn, Ashland, Bayfield area where you're hanging out. Or for me, a lot of this happened in the Eau Claire area. Mm-hmm. You have a lot of talented people, but because everybody is pretty much relatively blue collar and hustling and trying to get the rent paid, there's not a lot of room for ego either. And so exactly what you just talked about has happened to me many times. And you've got your, you know, here's my little song with its three chords. And then somebody shows up who's world class, but they have no issue with sitting in with you and like
yeah.
making your stuff better.
Yeah. It's awesome.
So you mentioned, Mark, that you came to music through Chopin in your mother's womb. What about you, Nate? What was your path?
My path was just, you know, sitting alone in my bedroom, and it was just sort of a way to deepen a friendship that I just kind of wanted to be like this good friend of mine who was a great guitar player at the time, and he had the patience to teach me one note at a time how to play. And I don't know, it just something wouldn't let me quit, no matter how hard my fingers hurt or how bad my fingers hurt, or no matter how bad I was at it. I just found that it was something that I could keep working at, and the more I worked at it, the better I got. And it was might have been my first experience having some gratification with something at that age. It's sometimes it's hard to come by at 15 14 15.
What about when was the first time you started playing in front of an audience of people that you weren't related to?
First time I played in front of an audience, I was 18 at Northland College, and the band did not show up. I was in the crowd. The band did not show up. And I was in the dorms at the time, and a couple people knew that I played guitar, and they were just like elbowing me and made me go get my guitar. And of course it was an amplified. It didn't have a pickup in it, or it was a old ratty acoustic. And I played one song, and I thought I was going to throw up. I didn't. But that was sort of like, yeah, the addiction was born, and it went from there.
Nate, this is funny. This is funny because we have never really talked about this too much. And I had this whole different picture in my mind that you were like born with a string in your hand and just like by osmosis could just play so smooth and everything, you know, but I don't know. It's fun to hear.
It was hard.
go ahead, Nate.
I was just going to say it was the opposite. It was a little more hard fought than that.
Definitely for me.
Yeah, how about you, Mark? When was the first time that you remember playing out, as they say?
Well, I started trumpet, and so I'd done a lot of band and jazz band, like, gigs with that kind of a thing. But first time with, like, a couple of guys, we got together and made music together. Our first gig out was on the Tremblay's Fudge Wagon in Hayward, Main Street. And we were opening up for, funnily, or humorously, I guess, Randy Sabine. And I just keep thinking now, and I've never talked about this with him since, but I keep thinking now he must have just thought we were so awful, so incredibly bad and terrible, you know. But he was very nice and gracious, of course, as he is. And that was definitely scary. Feeling, but also exhilarating, and I wanted more right away.
That's funny. I'm not a natural performer. I'm quite shy. I prefer to stay at home in my little room. But there's something about that first positive reaction in front of an audience where you go, I think I can overcome my shyness and do this again. Yeah. I also love that you told the two things, that playing on the Fudge Wagon, and the story about Randy Sabine. I have my own. I've embarrassed him with it in public, but I remember when I first started writing, and I was writing poetry, and I was writing essays, and I was writing humor, and I was trying to write songs, and it was all pretty bad, and I had no idea what I was doing. And Randy Sabine was the only name I'd ever heard of someone in the area who was a professional musician. And so I wrote some song lyrics and I mailed them to him, and I did the thing that people do. You know, I said, hey, I've got these lyrics. If you'd like to put them to music, you know, maybe we could.
And he just wrote back the kindest, sweetest note and, you know, found a way to say, no, run along. But did it so gently and so encouragingly that it was years before I ever shared a stage with him. And I was able to tell him that story and thank him about how he handled it. But it sounds like we all have a beginning with Randy Sabine story.
You wonder how many of those are out there. You know, we're probably not that small of a club, actually.
It also has helped me because all the time people will send me, you know, I want you to write this book with me and we'll split the money and all this.
Yeah, how to deal with that.
Yeah, and what I've never forgotten was that even though I have to say no, I remember how Randy said no. And he did it gently. And when I read those notes now, I just remember how earnest I was when I wrote that note. And mm-hmm. So that's enough good stuff about Randy. We don't want it to go to his head.
Yeah, we can't let his head get too big here.
And then when you mentioned playing on the Fudge Wagon, I was just flashing back to like all the places I've given readings on an equipment trailer, a cable, on top of a piece of plywood, on top of a pool table in a health food store. So I'm sure you all have those same stories.
Oh, yeah. We thought the tent was going to come down on us this last weekend.
Oh, wow. Oh, you were up there during... That's right. I was out in the woods hunting, and it was windy. Is that what you're referring to?
Well, we played our first gig for people in months at the brewery up in Superior. This brewery. And we had a good time. It was really fun, but, you know, it was chilly. And when I got up that morning, I got gas out here, and in Washburn, it was windy. I thought, oh, Superior is going to be terrible. Man, I was right. So it was a little scary at the end, but it was a really fun day. Good to get out there again.
That's one thing all those Southern rockers never experienced. You know, you're a good Northern Wisconsin performer if you've ever seen your breath while you're singing or reading a poem.
Many times.
4 days ago.
I tell you what, fellas, I sure appreciate your time, and I loved the music, and I got a sneak preview, of course, and it's lovely harmony, and there's just also there's a relaxed ease to what you do that shows your professionalism, but also shows the history that you have with each other on stage, and it really comes through. So thanks for taking the time to talk to us, and we'll see you down the road, maybe inside the tent with actual people in it one day.
Yeah, right. Step by the place. I'll buy you coffee sometime.
All right, and maybe we can do a show on the Fudge Wagon one day.
That would be awesome. Yeah, I just can't wait to meet you in person. I really appreciate this, and thanks for your time tonight.
Thank you. See you down the road.
Basically, what you learned there is we will play anywhere under any circumstances. But given a choice, we would prefer to play at the Big Top. So let's return there now for more from Two Below Zero.
One, two, three, four. It was back in Blind Ridge.
62, when I last saw you alive. But we miss that shift on the long decline, getting to that surf on time.
Transdermal celebration causes slight mutation in the rift. Topple down a nation, let the people run and fall ahead. But the mutants that I see shine their beauty unto me. I wish you could see them. Tectonic tribulation formed a crust of green beyond the reef. Waves fell in formation, causing plants to bend with speckled leaves. Touch them. Jets flew information, I could see them.
on the lawn. He's already home when the morning rain hits his face.
A big thank you to all who are supporting the musicians and the servers and the cooks and all those people, you know, having a hard time. I think we'll all get through it together. This little song I wrote quite a few years ago, but it seems to me like no matter who, what politicians are in office, it seems relevant. Tuesday night, you're in the snug. You're watching Betty's sweaty rug. You love them all to see the heat you're packing. Furry collar, fleecy vest, your haircut sharp, it frames the rest. The jury is impressed by your selection. Acting like it's the end of the Cold War, making all them business people drool. Acting like it's the end of the Cold War. You're a player now, the politics of cool. Silly louse, you filled your house with yay-sayers who ain't gonna bail you out. The legacy you're leaving is shameful. Business class and suits of glass, beware the rock is gonna bust your ass. We still got some class, Lord knows it's been tarnished. No, so could you. New coat of varnish. You're acting like it's the end of the Cold War, making all them politicians drool. Acting like it's the end of the Cold War. You're us player now, the politics of cool. Bride of the nation, she got pride and two other things. Make her ideal for the husband. When he's used her up, he'll stop and fill his cup with the blood from another freshly slaughtered lamb. You're the ones who got us into this chain. She got pride and two other things to make her ideal for her husband. But when he's used her up, he'll stop and fill his cup with the blood from another freshly slaughtered lamb.
end of the Cold War, making all them business people true, acting like it's the end of the Cold War. You're a player now, the politics of cool. You're a player. Politics of cool.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mark. I love playing that song, and I thank you every time I get to.
You know, it's going to sound pretty sappy, but I always think of you when I think of when I hear this song or think of it. So, great guy.
That's not sappy at all.
Fall is here, hear the yell, back to school, ring the bell. Brand new shoes, walking blues, climb the fence, books and pens. I can tell that we are gonna be friends. So I can tell that we are gonna be friends. Walk with me, Susie Lee, through the parking by the tree. We will rest upon the ground. Look at all them bugs we found. Safely walk to school without a sound. Safely walk to school without a sound. Here we are, no one else. We walk to school by ourselves. Vested on our uniform for chasing all them ants and worms. We clean up and now it's time to learn. So we clean up and now it's time to learn. Numbers, letters, learn to spell. Nouns and books in show and tell. Playtime, we will throw the ball. Back to class, through the hall. Teacher marks our height against the wall. Teacher marks our height against the wall. We don't notice any time pass. We don't notice anything. We sit side by side in every class. Teacher thinks that I sound funny, but she likes the way you sing. Tonight I dream while in my bed. My silly thoughts go through my head about the bugs and the alphabet. When I wake tomorrow, I bet that you and I will walk together again. 'Cause I can tell that we are gonna be friends. 'Cause I can tell that we are gonna be friends.
Is it true that Alex Chilton played here once? We don't know. I would have loved to have seen that. Of course, he was a pivotal member of Big Star, pretty great band that influenced a lot of musicians to follow them. Here's one of their songs. Years ago, my heart was set to live.
been trying hard against unbelievable odds. It's so hard in times like now to hold on. Guns ain't way to be stuck by, and at my side is God. You down, stand you in a row. No, you don't have to. You can just say no.
Thank you so much. Really grateful for the opportunity to be up here and sharing with all you in this time we're in right now. So thanks for the opportunity.
Thank you.
Well, folks, that's our Tiny Tent Show for tonight. Thanks to Nate and Mark of Two Below Zero. And thank you to our sponsors, Peggy and Ed Callahan, in honor of their anniversary. Jim and Joy Perry, Fiorio Wealth Advisors, Von Holzen Chevrolet Buick GMC, Haukaas Law, Anna Biermeier and Roger Hanson, Ringenberg Financial Group, Mary Lou and Pat Irvine, Roger and Sharon Schaver. If you can join these sponsors in supporting Tiny Tent Show, Lake Superior Big Top Chautauqua, we certainly welcome it. We're aware that many of you have already been digging deep, and we do not take that for granted. Again, there is a virtual tip jar up, and you can contact the Lake Superior Big Top Chautauqua offices and donate directly as well. More than ever, we thank you for your time and attention. Man, we are headed into the cold heart of winter. We need to stick together. We'll be here. And we know that you will too. The time has come, however, for now, for this week, not to say goodbye, but rather to do as they do where I'm from and just say, well, I suppose. Forward.